Hi students, we are actually discussing engineering mathematics 1 for diploma students of Tamil Nadu. Okay, this is where we stop in the last session. Okay, matrix inversion method. So this method can be applied only when the coefficient matrix is a square matrix and non-singular. Coefficient matrix means the A matrix should be a square matrix and it should be non-singular. That means determinant shouldn't be zero. Consider the matrix equation in the form of this Ax equal to b, where A is a square matrix and it is non-singular. Hence, A is non-singular, A inverse exists. Okay, so A inverse into A into A inverse equal to I. That is a basic definition of inverse, right? So, we will multiply A inverse on both sides of Ax equal to b. So, A inverse into A equal into x equal to a inverse into b, so x equal to a inverse into b. Okay, so this is the formulation for matrix inversion method. That means you can find out the unknowns not only by using Cramer's rule, you can also find out those unknowns using matrix inversion. Okay, so this method also can be used for finding the solution of linear equation. So that is what I am telling. So let's see some workload examples. This is one equation, this is another equation, right? So 2 5 1 2 and x comma y minus 2 minus 3, this is A matrix, this is x matrix, and this is B matrix. So what is x? A inverse into B. So let's find out A inverse. 1 by det A into adjoint A, that is A inverse. Det A is 4 minus 5 is minus 1. What about adjoint A? First you need to find the adjoint of this one is 2. Okay, for this one here it is minus 1. Okay, here it is minus 5 and this one is going to be 2. So this is adjoint matrix, that is correct. So A inverse is 1 by minus 1, this, that is minus 2 plus 5, 1 plus minus 2, whatever it may be. Now you have to multiply A inverse into B to get the unknown matrix, that is x. Okay, in this case x comma y. So minus plus 4 minus 15 plus 4 minus 15, that should be the first element. Let's see second element, first row, first column. Yeah, plus 4 minus 15 and this one minus 2 plus 6. Okay, that is minus 11 plus 4. So x is minus 11, y is 4. Okay, now this is 3 by 3, that is 3 unknowns. 2x plus, these are the equations. What is A? 2 3 3 first row, second row 1 minus 2 1, third row 3 minus 1 minus 2. Okay, B matrix 5 minus 4 3. Okay, x matrix you already know. Let's find det A first. You need to find then the cofactor for matrix adjoint A is cofactor matrix of A transpose, right? So you need to find the cofactor for each and every individual element. Okay, to find the adjoint. Okay, then you can transpose it to find the adjoint. Okay, once you got the adjoint matrix, 1 by det A into adjoint A will give you the A inverse. Okay, let's see. Yeah, this is adjoint, this is A inverse, then you need to multiply with B. Okay, so the solution is 1 2 minus 1, right? So the method is going to be same every time you're following the same pattern. Okay, let's see one example, one exercise at least. Okay, right, the first one is a two element one, quite simple anyway. But let's not do it here, let's get a separate sheet. Oh, what happened? Something. Okay, when I, okay, These are the equations. We need to write those equations somewhere. Here we will write. So this is the equation. Okay, let's write the equation in this form. Okay, then let's figure out what are those matrices in Ax equal to b. A equal to 2 minus 1 and 3 2. Okay, that is A. Fine, that is simply coefficients of x and y in the same order. Okay, fine. Anyway, okay, what about B matrix? Whatever is there after the equal to, that belongs to your B matrix, right? So 8 is the first equation. Okay, that is how we are taking it. Second equation will be minus 2. Okay, so bracket closed. So this is a column matrix. Now what you need to find? A inverse you need to find. How to find A inverse? First you need to find det A. What is det A? Det of A equal to 4 plus 3, sorry, plus 3 equal to 7. Okay, once you found det A, what you have to do? Find adjoint. We will find the adjoint in a single step, no problem. Adjoint of A equal to what? For this number, 2 is the adjoint. 2 is the digit here. What about this? Minus 3. Okay, so this it is plus 1. So here it will come plus 1 because you are transposing it, right? So minus 3 will appear here. Okay, otherwise I can directly give you in a different form. I will give it now. Last one is what? 2. You will get 2 only, right? This is adjoint matrix. For any 2 by 2 matrix, you can find the adjoint simply by remembering this method. Okay, AB, let the elements be ABCD. AB minus CD, AD minus BC is the det. Okay, determinant is going to be, if this is the matrix, some matrix R, okay, our determinant of this matrix will be AD minus BC, right? What about adjoint? Adjoint of R is nothing but, for A it will be D. Okay, for next C it will be minus B. So minus B will appear here. Okay, and here it is minus C and A. Okay, this is adjoint. You can directly use this one if you want. Okay, depending upon the number of marks awarded for the problem, you can go like this also. Okay, this is 1 by AD minus BC, D minus B minus C, A. Okay, see, in this case A and D are both are same, so the same number here. this is minus b, this is minus c, fine, right. Now what is A inverse? Inverse of A equal to what? 1 by dot A into adjoint A, so 1 by 7, 1 by 7 into adjoint is 2, 1, wait a minute, okay, 2, 1, minus 3, comma 2. Okay, so this is A inverse. So what you want, what we finally want is x. X is what? X equal to inverse of A into B, right? So it is going to be 1 by 7. You can directly copy this one. Oh, wait a minute. Right. Okay. Okay. Into B is there, right? Into what is B? Okay, what is B? B is 8 minus 2. 8 here, minus 2 here. Okay, right. Then what is the final answer then? Then this is going to be equal to 1 by 7, keep it aside, into, that is again a column matrix. 2 into 8 is 16, 1 into 2 is minus 2. 16, no, not 116, 16 minus 2. Okay, that is going to be your first element. What about the second element? Minus 24, minus 4. Yes, minus 24, minus 4. Oh, you better not to give any space. Otherwise, it will look like a 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, it is actually 2 by 1 matrix. This you might be aware of, 2 by 2, we are multiplying with 2 by 2 and 2 by 1. So the result will be 2 by 1 only, right? Right. Okay. So this is going to be 14. And this will be minus 28. Minus 28. Okay. Again, it can be simplified, right? All or these two, 14 and 28, both are factors of 7. So this is 7 2 is a 14, 7 4 is a 28. So this is going to be 28. Sorry, 4 minus 4. Okay, right. So this is your x, that means x is 2, y is, oh, this is actually capital X, right? In x equal to b, x is capital, this is x comma y, 2 comma minus 4 is the solution. Okay, x equal to 2, y equal to minus 4. Let's check this. Okay, let's verify the result. Okay, x equal to 2, y equal to minus 4. If you substitute here, 2 into 2 is 4, 4 plus 4 is 8. That is correct. This equation is satisfied. What about the second equation? 3 into 2 is 6, right? Minus 2 into 4 is 8. So minus 8. 6 minus 8 is minus 2. This is also satisfied. So the result is correct. That should be with the red mark. Wait a minute. Now it is going to be right. Not at all. Why it is black again? Okay, leave it, no problem. Let's solve the second one. Now I will solve only any one of these two, because these two are 3 by 3. Okay. Let's solve the B1 only. Okay. Class C. What we have done already here. Okay. But the method is not going to be same, right? We need to find the inverse. This is delta method. But anyway, what I suggest is, up to here it is fine. Okay. So that much we can make use of here, right? Now let's go back and have this one instead of this one. The equation got changed like this. Okay. This element is 2, next will be 3, next will be minus 1. That is perfectly fine. This is 1, next is 1, next is again 1. Okay, last one is 3 here, minus 1 maybe, right, minus 1, again minus 1. Okay. Right. 2, 3 minus 1, 1, 1, 1. There should be a gap. Right. 1, 1, 1, 3 minus 1, minus 1. Fine. What about the B matrix? 9 here. Again, 9 here. This is minus 1. Minus 1. Okay. What about delta now? We need to find the determinant of A, right? Delta, this is not delta, this is determinant of A now. 2 here, okay, sorry, 2 here, plus 1, no, minus 1, plus 1, right, minus 1, plus 1, it is going to be 0. Yes, minus 1, plus 1, yeah. Next, minus 3, minus 1, minus 3, minus 4, that is correct. Minus 1, minus 3 is minus 4. Next, minus 1 into minus 1, minus 3. Okay, every time we are getting minus 1 into minus 3, y like that. Okay, minus 1 into, oh, these are same. That is the reason why you are getting minus 1, minus 3 is minus 4. So this is minus 4. So first one is 0. Second one is 12. That is correct. Third one is 4. How much it is? 16. Okay. So this is determinant of A matrix. What you need to find now is adjoint. First we will figure out what is cofactor of A matrix. Okay. Then we will find adjoint. Cofactor matrix of A. Okay. Now each element, see, for 2, we need to find the first order, second order determinant of this matrix. That is 0, right? Minus 1 plus 1. That is 0. So the element will be 0. This one, eliminate this row, this column. Find the determinant. Minus 1, right? Minus 1, minus 3, minus 4. So next one is going to be minus 4. Last one is also minus 4. Okay. You have to eliminate which row? First row and third column. Minus, and find the second order determinant of this matrix. Minus 1, minus 3. Okay. That is cofactor. Okay. Okay, fine. What about... what about this element? What is this element? This row, this column, you have to eliminate. Minus 3 plus 1. Okay, minus 3 plus 1. How much it will be? Minus 2. So minus 2 is going to be the first element. What about the second element? Like this. Minus 2 plus 3. That is 1. Third element, eliminate this row, this column. Going to be minus 2 minus 9. Minus 2 minus 9 will be minus 11. Okay, space is needed, right? Now we need to find it out for this matrix. Sorry, this row 3. For 3, eliminate first row, first column, third row. Find the determinant of this. 3 plus 1, 4. So write 4 here. And then for this, eliminate third row, second column. And find the determinant of remaining elements. 2 plus 1, 3. Okay. And for the last element, eliminate the third row and third column. Find the second order determinant of these four elements. 2, 3, 1, 1. 2, minus 3. How much? Minus 1. Okay. That's it. This is your cofactor matrix. I did a mistake here. I told you cofactor matrix, this is plus sign. This is minus, okay? If you go back and look, this plus, this is minus, this is plus again. Why? It should be minus 1 whole power I plus j. Not just finding the minor. Whatever we found out, that is minor, okay? But cofactor is sine and minor, right? So what you need to do actually is minus 1 whole power this first row, second column, minus 1 whole power 3 is minus. Okay, this is plus, this is minus, this is plus, no problem. And this is minus, this is plus, this is again minus. Okay, if you use that formula, that is how you will get. This is plus and this is minus. This is okay. Okay, this is your cofactor matrix. Otherwise, they are simply minus. Okay, now what you need to do? Transpose. Adjoint is nothing but transpose of cofactor matrix. Adjoint A equal to transpose of this. Okay, so I am directly writing the transpose 0, 0, 2, 4. That is first column, right? That will be become first row. Okay, second column 4 becomes second row, 4, 1, minus 3. That becomes your second row. Third column becomes third row, minus 4. That is what transpose is, right? Either you interchange rows or columns, so you will end up getting the same matrix. Okay, so this is going to be your adjoint matrix. Okay, what about A inverse then? Inverse of A is inverse of A equal to 1 by det A into adjoint A, right? What is det A? 1 det A is 16, so 1 by 16 into, so this matrix, this thing, this slow process. Alright. Okay, let's move on. Keep it down. Everything is okay. Yes, everything seems fine now, except this. Okay, this is inverse of A. What is x? X equal to A inverse into B, this into B. So let's find x. X capital X, the unknown, so unknown matrix, inverse of A into B. Okay, so going to be inverse of A, you already know. Okay, we can directly use that one. Perhaps it is getting too longer here. Okay, so we'll keep it here. Okay. That is our what matrix? Inverse of A matrix, whatever B, 9, 9, minus 1. Okay, we can write it here. Okay. Nine. Okay. Why am I struggling here? Keep it here, no problem. let's copy this one only. That is B matrix, right? Here it is. Here 9, 9, -1. Okay. This into this now. Equal to 1/16 is common. Okay. Again brackets open. This is going to be again 3/1 matrix. 3/3 into 3/1 is 3/1 matrix, right? So 0 into 9 is 0, 9 into 2 is 18. So first element is going to be 18 -4. Okay, this into this is 4. So that is going to be your first element. What about second element? Second element is 36 plus 9. 4 into 9 is 36. This row and this column you have to multiply. 4 into 9 is 36 plus 9 plus 3. Plus 3 minus 1 into something. Minus 1 into something is plus 3. Minus 1 into minus 3 is plus 3. That is your second element. What about the third element? Third element is going to be minus 36. This into this plus this into this. That is plus 99. And plus this into this, that is plus 1. Okay. Right. Okay. Now what we are going to do? We will do again once again the same thing. 1/16 we will write it here. And then 18 - 4 is how much? 18 - 4 is 4, 14, and 36 plus 9 is 45, 45 plus 3 is 48, right, and this is 99 plus 1 is 100, 9 - 6 is 3, 9 - 3 is 6, 63, plus 1, 64. So I'm getting it out here in the first element. Did we make a mistake? I'm not sure. Let's see why we got 40. Okay, let's go back and see. See here, x plus y plus z equal to 9, right? X plus y plus z equal to 9. That means this is 3, this is 4. This has to be 2 then. Okay. It cannot be 14. So now I am sure that there is a mistake here. So from where the mistake came, we will figure it out. No problem. Let's see. In the cofactor matrix only there will be, I think. This element we will check first. This row and this column. Minus 3, minus into minus is plus, so minus 1, minus 4, so that is minus 4, minus 4 means this is 4, okay, not 2, this is minus 2, plus 3, so this is 1, this is correct, minus 2, minus 9, that is 11, that is correct. Now this one 3 plus 1 4, okay, this one 2 plus 1 3, that is minus 3. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. Okay, other things no problem. So this is going to be 4. So there is only one element change. Okay, so everywhere we'll change it to 2 to 4. Okay, 4. Now you have to look at here. 4 into 9 is 36. Right? 4 into 9. Yes, 4 into 9 is 36 minus 4. So this is going to be 36 minus 4 is 32. Okay. Right, one more step we will write it now. Okay. Write it here. 1/16 is no longer needed, right? Okay. So 32/16 is 2. 48/16 is 3. And then the last one is 4. Okay. 2, 3, 4 is now the solution then. Okay. That we can verify here. Let's keep 2 here. Okay. Now we add them. X plus Y plus Z. 5 plus 4, 9. Okay. You can check the other things as well. Other equation. 4 plus 9, 13. 13 minus 4 is 9. This equation is also satisfied. 6 minus 3. Minus 4. 6 minus 7 is minus 1. So the solution is correct. We can tick the solution now. That is verified. Okay. Third thing you can do similarly. We'll complete this exercise and we'll stop. Okay. A man is appointed in a job with a monthly salary of certain amount and fixed amount of annual increment. If his salary was 19,800 per month, at the end of the first month, after 3 years of service, at the end of the first month, after 3 years of service, and 23,400 per month at the end of the first month, after 9 years of service. Okay, if his salary was this per month at the end of the first month after 3 years of service. Okay, this per month at the end of the first month after 9 years of service. And his starting salary and what is this? Find his annual starting salary and his annual increment. Use matrix inversion method. Okay, that is what you have to do. So we will formulate the given situation. Okay, let's x be the starting salary. Okay, x be the starting salary of the person. Okay, and what about y as the annual increment? Okay, increment for a year. So after 3 years, so that means 3 into y equal to how much? After 3 years, it is 19,800. Okay, that is one. What about the other equation? After 9 years, that is 9y. Okay, going to be 23,400. This you have to change. 23,400. Now we got two equations, right? Now we can proceed with these two equations to get the unknowns using the same method, whatever the method we used last time for the 2x2 case. Okay, here are the equations, right? Right. Okay, let me get the equations first. Let's get the equations first. Right. Oh, why like that? Oh, fair enough. Okay. X plus 3 by 19,800. X plus 9 by. This is not needed now. Okay, x plus 9 by 23,400. So these are not the equations. These two are the equations. Now what is A matrix? 1 here, 3 here, B 1 here, 9 here, right? just the coefficients of a and x and y. 1 3 1 9. Okay, 1 3 forms first row, 1 9 forms second row. What about the B matrix? 19,800 is the first one, first row. Second row, 23,400. Okay, right. What is delta dot A? 9 minus 3. That A is 9 minus 3 equal to 6. Right, 9 minus 3 is 6. What about adjoint? D here, that is A here. Sorry, D here. A here, 1. DA minus B minus C. That means minus 3 here, minus 1 here. Okay. Yes, fair enough. Okay. Okay, D A minus B minus C. Okay. What is inverse? 1 by dot A is 6 with adjoint A. Adjoint here 9. This is minus 3. Next is minus 1. This is 1. Okay. Okay. Right. Now x is A inverse into B. Wait a minute. It is disturbing us. Oh, these two got pasted. Okay, no problem. Okay, inverse of A is 6 here. 9 here, minus 3, minus 1, 1. This one is 19,800. What about this one? 23,400. Okay. Okay, here what we have to do is, you see, these are big numbers, right? We need to reduce them. Okay, this is a factor of what? They both have some common factor. That is 600. Okay, so 600 means 198 by 6 is how much? 33. No, 18. 18 is a common factor. 198 by 18 is 11. Okay, so I'm taking out 1800. Okay, 18 actually. Hundreds are also there, right? So that also I'm taking out. Denominator is 6 anyway. Then this becomes what? It becomes, we have to write the whole matrix again. 9 minus 3, down it is, minus 1, 1 I guess, right? Up to here no problem, keep it there. Okay, now I need to write the matrix, right? Which matrix? This kind of matrix. Okay, how much it is? It is going to be 11. If you take 1800 there, it is going to be 11. This is going to be 13. Okay, now our job is made simple. Okay, so finally 1800 by 6 is 300. Okay, this thing you have to multiply. 99 99 minus 39, right? 39, yeah, 39. This is minus 11, minus 11, plus 13, plus 13. Okay, right. The final step we are going to write below, okay, because of the space constraint. Final two more steps may be needed. This is 39 09 60. 60 is this. What about this? 2 13 11 2, right? Right, okay. Again, one more step may be needed. The final step, 300 into 60 is how much? 300 into 60, 18,000. Yes, 18,000. What about this then? 300 into 2 is 600. Okay, that's it. So 18,600, that you can verify, I guess. X is 18,000. Initial salary is 18,000. Okay, that is X. In our case, it is X. Our X is 18,000. Y is 600. How to verify? Just substitute them. 18,000 here, 1800 here. 18,000 plus 1800 is 19,800. That is correct. 18,000 here, 5,400 is here. Both will be 23,400 only. So the answer is correct. But where to write the answer? Here write the answer and put a tick mark. Okay, that is verified. This is also belongs to this problem. Okay, last problem perhaps. That is last problem only. 4 men and 4 women can finish a piece of work jointly in 3 days, while 2 men, 5 women can finish the same work jointly in 4 days. Find the time taken by one man alone and that of one woman alone to finish the same work by using matrix inversion method. Okay, first you need to formulate, right? First you need to write the equations. 4 men and 4 women can finish a piece of work jointly within 3 days. Okay, 4 men means okay, we need to formulate it. How to formulate it? Let's see. Let's say men alone, one man alone can finish that work in a number of days. That is not Q, a number of days. Okay, and one woman alone can finish that work in b number of days. Okay, is that clear? Right. Now one man, if he works for only one day, how much portion of work will be completed? That will be 1 by A. Okay, 1 by A for a man. This much portion he will, portion of work, one man, one day, okay, not a day, one day, D for day, completes 1 by A part of work. Okay, and one woman in one day completes 1 by B portion of the work. Okay, is this clear? One man one day completes 1 by A portion of the work. One woman one day completes 1 by B portion of the work. Now 4 men, 4 women, that we need to figure it out, right? I'm keeping it here. This is not important anymore, right? Now 4 men means 4 by a, okay, a plus 4 women. 4 women means 4 by b, okay. In one day, this is all in one day, okay. So 4 men, 4 women can complete in 3 days. That means in one day they are going to complete 1/3 portion of the work. So this is equation 1. What is the other equation? The other equation is going to be 2 men, that is 2 by a, 5 women, that is 5 by b, can finish the same work within 4 days. That means in one day they will only do 1/4 of the work, okay. So formulation has been done, okay. Now what you need to do, how to solve? It is difficult if you keep on if you go for LCM method, LCM and a into b, that's quite difficult. Better to take 1 by a as x, okay, x equal to 1 by a, y equal to 1 by b, okay. So 4a, 4x plus 4y equal to 1 by 3, 2x plus 2y equal to 1 by 4. Now you can easily solve, right, using the earlier method. You solve that one. I am going to give the answer directly. Where I will write, here I have to write. These two equations are important for you, okay. And this one anyway, I can keep it here. So I am going to give the values of a and b directly. A is 18 days and b is 36 days. Yes, 36 days. And the answer has been verified, okay. You can cross check. That is 1 by a is 18, sorry, x is 18, y is 1 by 36. That is how you have to get. A means if a man can complete this work in 18 days. B means a woman can complete this work in 36 days. Okay, that's it. We need to discuss Gaussian elimination method, but the video is getting longer. So we'll stop it here. We'll proceed from Gaussian elimination method in the next session, okay. Nandri, vanakkam.